Good morning and welcome to the Daily Devotion from Stirling Baptist Church, where every day we are turning our focus toward God as members of our church bring us reflections on His goodness. For more information about Stirling Baptist Church, go to stirlingbaptist.org and you're welcome to get in touch with us through our Facebook page or by emailing us at admin@stirlingbaptist.co.uk.
Hello, my name is Wendy Hamlett and I'm married to Neil. We have three children who are now all grown up and married, and we have three small grandsons. I'm a teacher and I work in primary school in support for learning, but you might know me from being involved in the worship team at church where I play the flute. For today's thought, I want to share with you one of my favourite Bible verses, which is found in Jeremiah chapter 29, verse 11, which says, "For I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord. Plans to prosper you and not to harm you. Plans to give you a hope and a future." So how are you in this stage of the lockdown restrictions? For some people, their work has increased and is even more pressurised than ever. Perhaps also includes homeschooling as well as their own work. Or maybe you are shielding a spouse or another relative. Some others have more time on their hands and are fortunate to be able to enjoy the opportunity to read or garden or cook or enjoy a hobby. Some folk are very worried about their finances and their children and their health in this pandemic. But for all of us, these are strange and difficult times. We don't know how or when the restrictions will end or how we will as a country recover from the lockdown and all its implications. But God knows everything. The verse I read from Jeremiah says in a different translation that God plans to care for us and not to abandon us. We don't know the future, but this verse says that God does, and He declares that He has a plan for us, for a future and a hope. The word hope has a feeling of trust in it. We are trusting God that He has our future in His hands. My dictionary tells me that hope is the optimistic state of mind that is based on an expectation of positive outcomes. Because we know God's character, we can expect with confidence that He will be involved in our future and in our post-lockdown lives. But there are some positives coming out of this crisis. Communities are caring for elderly and vulnerable people, and neighbours are helping each other out. Homeless people have been found accommodation. And as a country, we're pulling together, and there are many unseen acts of kindness. The planet is healthier, with fewer cars and planes moving around, and even the birds seem happier. Families are out walking and cycling and enjoying exercise and time together. And many of us are realising that the people in our lives matter more than we ever thought. And maybe we will appreciate our friends and family even more when this is all over. Perhaps the new normal will be a better normal. Recently, I heard the story of a 93-year-old man who was in hospital in Italy. The staff at the hospital explained that he would have to pay for the use of a ventilator, and the man began to cry. The doctors and nurses thought that he was worried about the cost. "No," the man said, "I realise that I've been breathing God's air all the 93 years of my life, and I've never paid for it. Do you know how much I owe God? I didn't thank God for that before." He had suddenly realised that the air in his lungs was thanks to God providing it. In that verse from Jeremiah, God declares that He has plans to prosper us and not to harm us, which will give us a future and a hope. But the next verse is also a good one to meditate on, as it says, "Then you will call on me and come and pray to me, and I will listen to you. You will seek me and find me when you seek me with all your heart. I will be found by you, declares the Lord. So today, I hope that you will be grateful for the knowledge that God has a plan for you. A plan to give you a hope and a future. As we continue to discover more about prayer on Sundays and in our small groups, I pray that we will, in these uncertain times, draw closer to our faithful God. I hope we will be grateful for the air we breathe, the friends we have, the food we eat, and the knowledge that we are God's loved children. Have a good day. God bless.